We actually do different things with the kids. My kids love to dance. They love to like just kind of go crazy. You can blame their Aunt Yolanda for that, actually. But we'll turn on just dance videos, or we'll turn on Zumba videos and get together, and I'll tell them, for this period of time, 30 minutes or whatever, maybe it's time before I do lunch, I want you guys to dance. And then I watch them. Hey, you have to keep moving, guys. If you're not sweating, you're not working. If you have the ability for them to go outside, I would do that as much as possible. But it's actually a necessity, especially for us, for our smaller kids. If I don't allow them time to kind of get their wiggles out, they're going to get them out in a way that I don't want them to. So you'd really need that time. But there's so many videos, there's so many different things that you can use to allow your children an opportunity to connect with a structured workout. There's a lot of things that are free, and that I put in Build Your Arsenal. I have YouTube lists of workout videos. I have YouTube lists of every different type of thing that I might want to mix together for the kids just to keep them occupied or busy or physically active at different times. Don't be afraid to go and look, because there's just tons of stuff out there. Here in Colorado, it's cold at different points in the year, and I can't just send the kids out in the backyard. So we need different things that, they can do right here in the living room. And for us, Just Dance has been one of those great things. They love it.
Social interaction is a big part of the education and the growth of for kids. And from a homeschooling point of view, how do you ensure that your kids get that social interaction with other kids? And well, before you answer that question, think about the current circumstances now where kids cannot go to play with their friends in their houses and can't go to school to burn up that energy with their friends. How do you manage that?
So normally we do the homeschool program, which our kids made a lot of friends in. But as we're doing the social distancing, we've actually gone to, hey, let's FaceTime video, my daughter has a very tight group of friends that she loves to get on FaceTime with and communicate with. I personally am not a huge fan of video games and the interactions on video games, but our kids also have a program they use called Adventure Academy, and they go on there and they can actually communicate with peers on that program, and it's much more protected. My son had a Roblox phase that we had to end. But if they have something that they're interested in doing or that they've been doing before, as long as you feel comfortable with it and secure with it, they can still have those opportunities to speak with friends. But FaceTime has been a great tool for us, for our very social butterfly daughter who wants to see her friends. So I even have a friend that her and several of her son's friends, I don't, that might sound weird, her son's classmates, they did like a dance party using technology. And I thought, how great is that? It gives them a unique opportunity to connect with each other and do something fun that maybe they wouldn't even ordinarily have a chance to do. So.
למידה מרחוק הזה, באמת, זה פשוט לא, זה בלתי אפשרי, זה לא נורמלי. מהבוקר, אנחנו רק ביום השני, מיליוני הודעות בוואטסאפ, יש לי ארבעה ילדים שיהיו בריאים, תדמיינו כמה וואטסאפים, כמה מורות לכל ילד, כמה מקצועות לכל ילד, יש לי רק שני מחשבים בבית, הם רבים מהבוקר על המחשבים, אחד המורים של הבת שלי חי בסרט שהיא בשמונה בבוקר תשב לראות אותו על המסך, היא בשמונה בבוקר רק הופכת צד במיטה, מה נראה לכם? המורה למוזיקה של הבן הקטן שלי, היא ש... בבוקר. מה אני אעשה עם המידע הזה? מה, אני, יש לי הרכב של איזו להקה? אני לא יודעת לקרוא תווים. שנייה, אני מוציאה קלרינט ויושבת עם הבן שלי לעזור לו עם התווים. בן, חבר'ה, מורים, תניחו ציפיות, זה לא הגיוני. וכל היום, איך הילד מרגיש? איך שצייר ציור? איך הילד מרגיש? הוא כל היום בפלאפון, טוב לו. ישנים טוב, אוכלים, לא מפסיקים לאכול. איך הוא מרגיש? שאלו אותי איך אני מרגישה.
Just a couple of things. Your mental health matters, and homeschooling can be so overwhelming. And there's a lot of different things that are happening for everyone right now. It could look different. Maybe your school is giving you a lot of resources and things for the students to do, which is awesome, right? Maybe your school isn't giving you a lot of resources and you have to build up your arsenal. There's a lot of things online that will help you, free resources and things like that that you can use. But at the end of the day, just remember, this is difficult for everyone. I've been doing this for 3 years, and I have a day sometimes that I'm like, throw your hands up, we're good, let's turn on a movie. Homeschooling is not happening today. It's just, no one's learning, mom wants to cry or have a bottle of wine, not a glass, you know, like when you start feeling that way, it's probably not going to be a super successful homeschooling day. And that's okay. It happens to everyone. So you want to make sure that you give yourself time for that mental health break that you need. You know, everything that you do when your kids are home, they're going to learn. They're learning from you all the time. So if homeschooling in a traditional sense of us sitting down and doing workbooks or whatever else isn't going great, then maybe look at other ways that you can teach them that are more, I don't know, out of the box. Break out the recipe book, bake a cake. You know, now we're doing math. Now I need you guys to read this to me. I've had the kids watch a movie about something historical, and then we're going to do a movie review. We're going to have a pretty deep discussion about it. I want you to do a write-up for me. Kids are resilient and they're amazing, and they're going to learn from whatever you put in front of them. So, you know, don't put too much pressure on yourself to be perfect in this process. It's not perfect for anyone, you know. Give yourself a break, give yourself some patience, and also listen to the kids. You know, there's going to be cues that they're going to give you that show you what they love, what works really well for them, and you might be super surprised to see what it is that they really like. My kids love taking spelling tests. Why? It's bizarre. I don't know, but they love it. So just listen to your kids, see what they like and what they're benefiting from, and then structure some of what you do around that. But it's going to be okay. It's going to be okay. Don't freak out, guys. It's going to be fine.
Right. I really like that point about protecting mental health. It's because, you know, under this whole new reality that we all have to live in, parents are having to still cope with their nights. So people who can work from home still having to cope with their 9-to-5s, but also have to do homeschooling. I mean, never before have we, if we've never appreciated teachers before and schools, I think now, I think maybe there needs to be a campaign for governments across the world to raise teacher salaries, honestly. But yeah, parents are dealing with that emotional stress of having to still carry on their 9-to-5s, but also have to do the homeschooling thing. So yeah, having that, you know, just removing that expectation from yourself and giving yourself some time to breathe, I think is a very important point. I'm sure the community appreciates this, the insights that you shared. Can I ask you if you're open to sharing some of your YouTube playlists, for example, that you talked about, so that I can maybe put a link in the comment section below this video?
Yeah, absolutely. And if the list that I put together doesn't really fit, you know, YouTube is so amazing and crazy. You just search for exactly what it is that you're looking for. And I have just pulled songs and different combinations of things that work. I let the kids watch it, and one day they're bored, and then we just pull stuff and put something else in. So I'm glad to share that with you guys. Absolutely.
Okay, awesome. Well, thank you very much, Delijah.